Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of No One But You. When we last left off, we had just broken into the school grounds to go look for a spoopy ghost. The midnight ghost, to be precise. And, so we split up into two groups. Ryu and somebody else, I can't remember her name now. I'm so sorry, girl. Ryu and the other girl broke off, and I decided to take Megumi with me since we've been kind of hitting off lately, pachow. So then we split off and we started investigating, so let's get back to the story. Megumi and I walked around the school, then went up to the second floor. Megumi stopped in front of one of the club rooms for a second, then went inside. Oh, it's a pretty nice club room. Hey, is something wrong?
No.
Are you sure? Your expression changed all of a sudden.
This is the student council room.
I noticed. Is something here bothering you? Megumi didn't answer and simply looked around the room.
Did you hear that?
Huh? Hear what?
It's like someone is calling for me.
Hey, wait. Megumi started running down the hallway. Crap, this is bad. Everyone knows the first rule of horror movies is to stick together. I need to follow her. Megumi, wait up. That's weird. Why would you just run off in the middle of a spooky ghost meetup? You know, like you're all just trying to meet up and look for spooky ghosts, and then you're just like, I'm just going to run off on my own. I'm like, that's not a good idea. We also are not supposed to be here, so the more people that are around that we can't keep track of, the more likely it is someone's going to catch us. I started running after Megumi towards the third floor. Third floor? Damn, how big is this school? Damn, she's fast. It's a good thing Megumi isn't trying to lose me or cover her tracks. The classroom door over there is open, so she's probably inside. I walked over to the classroom and went inside. As I walked in, I saw Megumi sitting on one of the desks in the middle. All she was doing was sitting there, looking at nothing. She seemed so lost and lonely. I've never seen Megumi act this way before. I almost miss her heart attack-inducing excitement. Hey.
Huh? Oh, Hideki. I'm sorry I ran off like that. I thought I heard something. But it was just the sound of the wind, it seems.
Megumi, what's going on?
It's nothing.
Don't give me that. If it were nothing, you wouldn't have ran off like that. You know I worry about you, so just tell me what's bothering you.
Hideki.
Megumi took a deep breath and began to unload.
There was this person, a girl who used to attend this school. She was really close to me, but now she's gone.
Gone? You don't mean...
Yes. For a second, I thought perhaps the midnight ghost was her. But it was silly of me to think like that.
I'm sorry for asking.
It's okay, Hideki.
Megumi stood up and walked closer.
Sorry. It seems like I just ruined the whole mood.
No, it's okay. I understand why you acted like that. But you scared me for a second back there. I really care about you, Megumi, so I hated seeing you like that.
Hideki. Me too,
Crap, my face feels really hot right now, and I don't know what to say. Let's go back to Ryu and Shiro. It's almost midnight.
Sure.
Okay, whew. Getting a little hot and bothered over here. Hey, the whole gang's here now. Great.
Oh, it looks like we're the last ones to return. Have you guys been waiting long?
Nah, we just got here.
Did you, find anything?
Nope. Just empty rooms. That's about it. What about you two?
Heh.
I looked at Megumi, who blushed as she thought back to the scene moments ago. No. We didn't find anything either.
Bummer.
Luckily for me, neither Shiro nor Ryu seemed to notice Megumi's change in expression.
Even so, we still have 5 minutes before midnight.
Ugh. Yeah, Ryu's right. Let's wait around a little longer. Taking Ryu's idea to heart, we stood there in the hallway and talked for a while. But the moment it hit midnight, we were all dead quiet. Nothing could be heard, not even the sound of us breathing. Everyone looked rather worried as the wind blew around the school. Okay, this silence is getting a bit terrifying.
What was that?
I don't freaking know. It came from the club room.
Oh, sorry, Shiro's voice is making me a little snotty. Sorry, just voice acting problems.
Should we go and check it out?
I'll go. You guys wait here.
Are you sure about this?
Yeah, don't worry. If something happens, I'll call out for you guys.
Just be careful, Hideki.
Don't worry, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, the noise came from this room right here. I slowly grabbed the handle and opened the door. Okay, everything seems normal in here. One of the boxes fell over, but how? Just then, I felt a hand on my right shoulder. What the hell? I quickly jumped forward and turned around. What the? Chinatsu? What in the world are you doing here?
I'm sorry I scared you like that. I saw you enter the school earlier and heard about your plan with the others. I wanted to join, but lost track of you on campus.
Oh, I see. So it wasn't the Midnight Ghost after all.
Nope.
You still scared the hell out of me, though. It's just a shame you weren't a soul-consuming ghost.
Sorry for bursting your bubble.
It's okay. Anyway, let's head back to the others.
Maybe we shouldn't.
What do you mean?
You guys came all the way here searching for a ghost. It would be a shame to disappoint them.
True. Ryu and Shiro would most likely be bummed by this. What should we do?
I'm sure you could come up with something to tell them. I'll leave through the black back door.
Alright, cool. Hurry, before they see you.
Okay, good luck, Hideki.
Chinatsu exited the room. Alright, time to have a good old-fashioned Hideki lying session. Hideki, what took you so long?
We thought something had happened to you. I was about to call the cops.
If you did, they'd probably be too busy arresting you to actually investigate. Anyway, when I reached the door, I started to hear a noise. It sounded like a girl talking to herself. I slowly opened the door and walked inside, only to see the silhouette of a girl behind the curtains. Everyone was looking at me while their eyes sparkled. I slowly walked towards it, but when I moved the curtains, there was no one there. I stayed in the room for a little while, then came back here. That's what happened.
Huh.
Whoa, that sounds awesome! So it could have been the ghost of a girl. Darn, we were so close.
Yeah, I wish I was with you to see it.
That does sound interesting.
I can't believe they actually bought that. I must be more persuasive than I thought. Putting a lot of stat bonuses to your charisma there, I see. That's a RPG joke, in case you didn't get it there.
This is exciting and all, but this place is starting to give me the chills.
Yeah, and it's getting late. Maybe we can come back again later and continue the investigation.
Okay, let's leave it at that for now. You locked all the doors, right?
Yep, it's like we were never here.
Good, I don't want to get in any trouble.
This was really fun, even though we didn't find much. Still, I enjoy spending time with you guys.
Me too.
Anyway, I should be heading home now.
Oh, same here. I'll walk with you.
Goodbye, you two.
Bye-bye.
Ryu and Shiro walked away. So, are you ready to go?
You mean, you're walking me home?
Of course.
Willingly, or on your own initiative, without being asked?
You said it yourself, didn't you? I can't let a cute young girl walk around alone in the middle of the night.
Cute, huh?
Oh crap, that wasn't what she said, was it?
Well then, what are we waiting for?
Megumi wrapped her arms around one of mine, tightly squeezing and making it difficult, very difficult to walk. Haha, this is what being honest gets me, huh? Not that I'm complaining, in fact, the soft sensation on my arm is... crap, what am I thinking? Wakideki, divert all blood flow to your legs, and no higher.
I don't know if that's how blood works. Not think of so, man. I think blood works in mysterious ways. It goes through your whole body, through your heart, through your brain, to your libido, I mean, to your legs. You know, the same thing, right? The pelvic region. Yo, young innocent boys. Let's see here. Thanks for walking home with me, Hideki.
Don't mention it.
This whole night was really funny, even with its ups and downs.
Yeah, I'd say it was a good experience overall. Are you sure your parents won't be upset that you sneaked out of the house?
Nah, they won't. What they don't know won't hurt them.
Can't argue with that.
Anyway, I'll get going now. See you tomorrow, Hideki.
Yeah, good night.
Night-night.
As I walked into my own home, I crept more quietly than ever before. Exercising a far more caution than at school, I didn't make a sound. My mother would freak out if she knew I sneaked out in the middle of the night. I should head straight to my room. I walked to my room, then immediately threw myself in my bed. Man, I am tired. I'm so tired. It was a lot of fun, though. Either way, I wonder what happened in Shinatsu. I hope she made it home safely.
She's the ghost.
Okay. Oh, we actually just went a day ahead. Well, that's nice. We're not skipping time crazy all crazy and crazy.
What a day. Oh, man.
Or rather, what a night. To think that we actually snuck into this place in the dead of night. Wait a minute. What am I doing here? I only just woke up. Did I fall asleep in class again? If so, I hope the teacher didn't notice. Huh. Hang on. Where is everyone? It looks like I'm the only one here. It's so quiet and empty. I moved away from the desk and walked towards the window. There's nobody outside either. Did I come to school on a Saturday without noticing? That does sound like something I'd do. Either way, if I'm the only one here, then I walk through the door and out of the classroom. As expected, it's empty out here too. It's just so quiet. As I approach the school entrance, I notice someone standing next to the school gate with their back towards me. Though it was hard to tell from a distance, they looked like a little girl. What is she doing here? Is she waiting for someone? No, that doesn't make any sense. I gotcha. No, that doesn't make any sense. There's no one else here. I better just go and ask her. I started walking towards the little girl. Hello there, little... Gah! Just as I was about to tap her on the shoulder, I felt something strike the back of my head. Oh, man, that was... Huh? Wait, what the hell is going on here? Why am I back in class? I was just outside, and... As I felt an increasing degree that something was amiss, I looked towards the front of the room. The board on which classwork would usually be written contained a single phrase. The words, "Why, Hideki," were written all over the whiteboard in black marker. What is going on here? Is someone playing a prank on me? I need to get out of here. This place is making me feel uncomfortable. Screw this place. Why did I even come here? I walked towards the stairs and started running down. What the? I continued running down the stairs. How do I keep running into the same hallway? This doesn't make any sense. I looked at the other end of the hallway and saw someone standing there. Huh? I can't really tell who that is, but I can see that their lips are moving. Are they talking to me? I can't hear them. I started walking towards the mysterious person. As I walked, I watched their expression constantly change from that of someone laughing to an expression of anger, to misery, and then back to laughter. Are you talking to me? No matter how much I walked, I wasn't able to reach them. It was as though I was walking in an endless hallway. Hey, who the heck are you? And what are you saying? The figure then disappeared momentarily, only to reappear behind me. I could feel their breath running down my neck as I slowly turned around.
I know what you're doing. You had better stop while you can.
I'm in my room? Unbelievable. Was that all just a dream? Great. Just what I need. Like one reoccurring nightmare wasn't enough. Are they supposed to mean something, or are they just random? No, calm down, Hideki. I'm sure I'm just worked up from all that crap we did last night. I freaked myself out by going ghost hunting, and that dream was the price I paid. As I wandered downstairs, dressed for school and ready to go, I joined my mother for breakfast.
Wow, E.D., you looked even more tired than usual.
I just had a bit of a restless night, I guess.
Really? You look like you sneaked out on a crazy adventure in the middle of the night.
What? That's ridiculous. I would never...
Calm down, Hedy. I was just kidding.
Yeah, I know. Though she certainly did nail it. Anyway, I guess I'll be off now. Those tests won't ace themselves.
All right, Hedy. See you at dinner.
Later, Mom. Oh, man. That was a weird dream. When I reached my classroom, the first sight to grace my eyes was that of Ryu and Shiro talking next to my desk.
Oh, there's the man himself.
Hello, Hideki.
Good morning, you two. Still discussing the paranormal?
After last night's awesome adventure, how could we not?
Yeah, we're trying to solve the mystery of the Midnight Ghost.
We should come to school at night again.
Mm-hmm. You guys shouldn't give this too much thought, especially with finals approaching.
I guess you have a point. Even so, we should let this go.
Yeah, this mystery needs to be solved.
Oh man, these two are just...
Oh, class is starting. I should return to my seat.
Yeah, we'll talk about this later.
Shiro and Ryu both returned to their desk and sat down. With my desk now free, I decided to follow suit, mere moments before the teacher walked in. After surviving the entire lesson in a state of semi-consciousness, break time arrived finally before I knew it. The classroom was nearly empty, leaving only myself and the teacher who was working on some papers. I guess I'll head to the cafeteria and grab something to eat. I stood up and started walking towards the door.
Hideki, can I have a word with you?
Sure.
It didn't seem like you were listening in class today.
Ah, crap. We were bound to have this conversation at some point. Should I just admit that I wasn't paying attention? Just tell the truth. Yeah, you're right. I think I spaced out for a moment there.
I figured as much. I've noticed you haven't been paying attention in class recently. I know you're new here, and you've made a lot of friends, but you seem to be too concerned about them, moving from one person to the next. You need to think more about yourself, especially with the exams being so close.
I guess you're right. I'll try my best to focus more.
I'm glad to hear that. Listen, I have some more boxes in my office that need to be moved in a literature club. Can you do that for me? You know, in exchange for me not giving you detention.
Yeah, sure thing, Teach.
Great, thank you.
Oh man, this teacher is a slave driver. Wow, these boxes are seriously heavy. Either that or I'm even more unfit than I thought. I opened the door to the club room. Upon entering the club room, I noticed a girl reading a book next to the window. She didn't pay the door any mind, she simply continued reading. Wait a minute, I know that girl. Chinatsu? As I called out to her, Chinatsu quickly turned to face me, wearing a confused expression as she did.
Hideki? What are you doing here?
She's not the ghost? That's weird. I thought she was a ghost. My teacher told me to move these boxes here.
I see.
I forgot that you were in the literature club. It seems like you're the only one here.
Yeah, I'm pretty much the only club member.
That's unusual. I didn't know they allowed clubs with only one member.
Typically that is the case, but no one uses this room. As you see, it's mostly used as a storage room, and all I need to engage in club activities are books, so...
makes sense. Can I join the club too?
Oh, you really want to be a part of it?
Reading is fun, but I mostly just want a quiet place I can relax in. I mean, if you're okay with that.
Certainly. I sometimes get bored being here by myself, so it should be fun.
Cool. So what are you reading there? It looks like a short novel.
It's called A Lone Universe.
Well, that sounds intriguing. What is it about?
The story is about a little boy who wakes up one day to find himself in this vast world. If you want, I can read some of it for you. I just started reading it myself.
Oh, sure. It seems interesting enough.
Okay, then let's begin.
Whoa, hold the phone. Before you start this amazing story you're about to read me, Chinatsu, I want to say thank you for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me why I'm the worst no-one-but-you player you've ever seen. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye!